G'day YouTube, Bushy here. Yeah, got a cold, blowing the froth off a few, just trying to kill all the cold or flu or whatever the fuck it is I've got. James Squires, Amber Ale, clone. It's not going down too badly. It's lost a bit of its head, but it's okay. It's got a bit of chill haze. Anyway, I was talking to a friend of mine today about the eternal argument that is continuously going on about all grain versus extract. I mean, hey, the way I see it is, whatever you brew, if you like drinking it, drink it. It doesn't have to affect anybody else. If it's crap beer and you like drinking it, then that's your problem. It's got nothing to do with anyone else, on the internet or fucking anywhere else. Just drink it. I mean, I'm an all-grain brewer, but I was an extract brewer. I have been for many, many years, and I still do extract brews now. If I run out of time, I don't use the crappy yeast that they come in the can. I go and get some decent yeast, you know. The thing I like about all grain brewing though is that I have the control. So if something screws up, it's my problem. You know, if it tastes like shit, I chose the grist. I chose the fucking hops. I chose the yeast. I chose the mash temperature. I chose the ferment temperature. So it's fucking my problem. Not that you can't choose your ferment temperature with the extract, but yeah, it's my fucking problem if I fuck it up all grain. And it gives me so much more control. I like all grain brewing, but every now and again, it gets to the point where I can't fucking all grain brew. Sometimes I have to fucking stop, and I haven't got the time, and I've got to do a extract batch. I mean, this weekend I'm doing fucking an extract batch because I'm running low on beer. So, yeah, that's it. Anyway, my phone is going off in the background. I've had my rant, so. Cheers. Keep drinking beers. See you later. Thanks for watching.